My name is Carl, and you're on the Internet of Bugs, which is both the name of this channel and also a description of the network between you and the server hosting this video. Don't get me wrong, the internet is a miracle of modern technology, and I wouldn't want to live in a world without it. But in many ways, it's also a dystopian nightmare. Quick introduction. This year is my 35th year as a computer professional, and my youngest offspring is now a college freshman majoring in computer science, which puts me in a situation of getting a lot of software career questions from a lot of college students. And I've started this channel to answer those questions for them and anyone else who might be interested. My perspective is somewhat different than most of the channels I've found on YouTube, because I've spent time both developing software and on the operation side of the industry, which means, unlike a lot of developers, I've experienced the pain of being woken up in the middle of the night by a pager, and I've lost sleep on hundreds of nights, cleaning up after some stupid bug caused a system crash, wiped out customer data, or allowed some hacker to get unauthorized access to a system. But I've also spent time as a programmer and as a manager, a consultant, and an employee of organizations ranging from tiny startups to giant behemoths like Amazon, IBM, ExxonMobil, and the US government. I love developing software, and I love solving challenging problems and making people's lives actually better. Being a developer sometimes feels like being an ancient mythical wizard. You put the right words and the right symbols in the right order, and that incantation, under the right circumstances, literally makes things happen in the real world. It's the kind of thing that medieval alchemists used to fantasize about. At the same time, this industry is a mess. Code today is built on more layers of dependencies than ever, and the quality of that code has been going downhill. That sounds like hyperbole, but it's not just an old guy yelling about how things used to be better in the good old days. This is a graph of the number of new vulnerabilities registered per year for the last 25 or so years. From 2005 until 2016, things were more or less steady, but 2017 had more than twice as many reports as 2016, and it's been rising every year since. We had almost 60% more new vulnerabilities in 2023 than we did in 2020. This is only one metric of code quality, but it's definitely an important one, and I'd argue it's pretty representative of what I've been seeing. It's also trending in a very, very bad direction. Now, I'm not going to pretend I have all the answers, but I have some ideas, and I definitely have opinions. I've learned a lot over the last 35 years, and hopefully someone will find what I have to say useful. I hope you'll come back to see, but either way, thanks for watching.